My name is Jonathan Ayres. I own Networked for Success, an IT company, and today we're going to talk about how to choose an uninterruptible power supply, also known as a UPS. Now the question arises immediately, how do I pick a UPS when there are so many available and what parameters do I look for? So let's start off by thinking about what a UPS actually is. A UPS is a battery in a box. And what is it used for? It's used to protect your computer from power outages and other power problems. You could have a power outage caused by the electricity company coming into your house or by a component in the computer breaking. It could be a fan or some other device that would want to turn the computer off or cause a problem with the way it's running. An uninterruptible power supply will provide electricity continuously for the amount of electricity that it has stored in the battery in its box. Now I have my arm resting here on an uninterruptible power supply, and inside this gray box that we're looking at here is just nothing other than a storage battery, just like you have in your car. This battery is providing power to your computer through various outlets on the back. And we look here in the back and we can see that we have a number of cords plugged in, and these cords will be going directly to your computer. And we also have some other possibilities on the back of a uninterruptible power supply. We have a serial cable outlet, and we also have protection for a telephone and a fax modem. And what that protection is basically not just to always provide electricity, but also for spikes in electricity. So it's always a good idea if you have a telephone or fax to have them plugged in if your power supply provides that. Now the serial port that I have my finger pointing at over here on this side is for monitoring the UPS. And the reason you'd want to monitor it is to see, you know, if the battery is being charged regularly or if it's providing a good level of electricity. Each company that makes an uninterruptible power supply has its own software program that will show you various states of the UPS at any given time if you want to monitor them. Typically, these are used by companies that are using power supplies for corporations that have a lot of computers and need to protect them, and then they have people that monitor them all the time. So when we're going to look for a power supply, we want to look for these different features, but mainly the number one issue we want to look at is there going to be enough energy in the battery to run my computer? So the question arises, how much energy does a computer take? Just one computer. And a regular desktop computer that you would have at your home would typically run between 400 and 600 watts. So when you go to look for a UPS in a store, they're going to have watt sizes on the outside of the box. It's going to say, here's a UPS that will provide you with 400 watts of power, 600 watts of power, 800 watts of power, 1200 watts of power. So if you had two computers, you'd want to go for an 800 watt power supply, uninterruptible power supply. So that would be how you'd pick one. And I would give you the rule to always look at whatever you have plugged in and multiply it times 1.5. So for example, if you had a 400 watt computer, buy a 600 watt power supply. That would be 1.5 times 400 or 600. And it would be the same thing for having multiple devices plugged in. So if you had your fax machine plugged in, you'd want to find out how many watts that fax machine operated on, add that into the equation, and then give yourself a 50% buffer or 1.5. This is a good way for you to be able to pick what type of uninterruptible power supply that you want to buy.